why do a bone marrow biopsy?
A bone marrow biopsy is a key element when we're trying to diagnose multiple myeloma and when we're managing multiple myeloma. It gives us a lot of information that is key to determine prognosis and establish a treatment for that patient. So when we do a bone marrow biopsy, there are several things that we can, information that we can obtain. We can obtain what percentage of the bone marrow is involved by myeloma. And we also obtain information about what mutations these cancer has. Do they have mutations that make this cancer high risk or standard risk? And the reason why we do that is because people who have aggressive mutations or high risk mutations, it tells us that this type of cancer might be harder to treat and is gonna be more prone to wanting to come back and can also affect the prognosis of the patient. People who have high risk disease have a harder cancer in terms of management, and they tend to have a shorter prognosis or a poorer prognosis than people who have standard risk. Those are some of the tests that we can do with a bone marrow biopsy. And in addition to that, we have now what's called a gene profiling, which we are doing under clinical trials so that we can have a better understanding of the whole map of that tumor. So a bone marrow biopsy tells us not just the amount of cells that are involved in the tumor, but it gives us a nice picture of what the characteristics of the tumor are and what can potentially make this aggressive or make it standard. And if there's anything that we can use to actually target it. If we have certain mutations in that patient, that may sway us to choose certain treatments over others. And now that we have targeted therapy, we can actually try to use some of those mutations to use treatment that targets those particular mutations. And a very good example that hopefully we'll have commercially available in the near future is venetoclax, which can target a mutation called translocation 1114. And that way we know that we can hone in on that particular cells that have that mutation and try to destroy them the best. Now that was the initial bone marrow biopsy. It gives us a nice initial picture of what we're dealing with. But that's not the only time we're gonna get a biopsy. We're gonna wanna know, as your treatment evolves, how the cancer is doing. And whenever we think that somebody has achieved a remission, we're gonna want to repeat the bone marrow biopsy and identify how many cells are left. And if there are any cells left, what type of mutations are there in those cancer cells? If we do not see any mutations left or any cancer cells left, then there's some additional tests that we can do called MRD testing. And MRD testing can be done by flow, or it can be done by a type of test called next-generation sequencing. And this is a more specific way of identifying cancer cells in the bone marrow. So when we do a bone marrow biopsy and we use the microscope by the pathologist to identify the cancer cells, I want you guys to picture looking at the moon with a telescope. If you look at the moon tonight with your bare eyes, you're gonna see a round circle and some changes in the colors. If you look at it with a telescope, you're gonna be able to see the craters. But if you were to use the Hubble telescope circulating Earth, you're gonna be able to see all the grains and particles that are on the surface of the moon. And that's what happens with a bone marrow biopsy. When we do the biopsy, we send it to the pathologist. The pathologist takes a look at it in the microscope and looks with their own eyes to see if they identify any cancer cells. After that, they do special stains called immunohistochemistry that helps light up specific or make it easier for them to identify cells. And that's almost like looking at the moon with a telescope. But then there's MRD testing that can analyze up to a million cells and identify one in a million cells for cancer. And that's even more specific. And even though this is a new technology and we're in the process of incorporating it to our day-to-day care, we still don't know where it's going to fit. So this is a study that we're doing under clinical trials. And we are doing outside of clinical trials for certain management, but it is not something that has been standardized throughout the care. But those are the main reasons why we do biopsies for a diagnosis and to confirm remission. We want to know how deep the remission is. And then there are other cases where we do biopsies when we suspect somebody has relapsed. And you might say, well, why do I need another biopsy if I already had one and you already know the mutations I have? But whenever cancer relapses, it doesn't necessarily come the same way it was before. It's gonna be mutated, it's gonna have different subclones or subpopulations, and we want to identify what mutations this new relapse has so that we can then go to the drawing board and be able to identify what would be the best therapy at that particular point. And we're gonna be repeating this bone marrow biopsies every time we suspect somebody relapses so we can be able to tailor treatment to the best of our ability because we don't want to be giving treatment that might give a lot of toxicities and not be effective.